Hey everybody, this is Greg Koopman. Just going to go over today how to set up a secret key from Azure Databricks and have that secret key stored in the Azure Key Vault. This particular example I'm going to show you will store the account key from a storage account in a secret key. But before I start that, let me just show you the code that I'm going to implant this secret key into. So here's a code, and if you watch one of my former videos on Databricks, this is the same example. We go through some tenant centers and that kind of thing, and some data. So I'm not going to go through that part of it. But really, when you go to connect to the data storage, you need an access key, right, in this particular scenario. So in the code, you see storage account, access key, and I hard code it right here. Okay, that's not what we want to do. Okay, that's not very professional. It's not a good way. What happens, you have all your developers, they all know that key. And let's say a developer leaves the company, then you probably should change all those the keys again, which is a real pain. So what you end up doing is using KeyVault to store all these keys secretly from the administrator point of view, and only the administrator can get to those keys and change those keys. All right, and the users, as long as you give them role-based access to the Databricks to run it, then they can go ahead and just refer to those secret keys from code, but they never know what the value of the secret key actually is. So you can always change them behind the scenes whenever you want, and they'll still work, and you don't have to change any of the code. That's what's very important about this whole thing. So let me just demonstrate this real quick. I'm really going to go through a few of them. Step one, I'm just going to set up a storage account key and the storage account access key. I'm going to run this again. This is a hard-coded way. This is the before, not the after. So I just ran that. It's attached to the cluster, and it should come back in just a moment. Should be coming back into smoke. By the way, if you like these videos or you'd like to subscribe, you know the deal, just press the buttons. Okay, so that came back fine. The next step, we just go ahead and establish an execution context, run that cell, and in this cell we create the location to the files. Again, you can look at another video to see how all this works. And the last one, I've already ran it before we started this, but let's run it again. Show you this still connects, so now it's running and it's going to list out some values from those files in that file storage right there. And I'm not going to go through the rest, just watch the other video if you'd like to see that. But the main thing we're going to do now is I'm going to go, as you see, this is my hard-coded key. What we're going to do is this one. We're going to take the same thing, but instead of having the hard-coded key present where everyone can see it, we're going to refer to a secret key from scope for demo 3, and it's called Databricks secret key 3, and that's going to pass that same account key behind the scenes to this method, to this notebook, and it will work. Okay, so that's what we're going to set up today, and then let's go and start ahead and move right into it. Now, what I want to point out first of all is there's many steps in this, right? So I'm going to list those down below the video, and we're going to refer to them as we walk through this, okay? Because it's a lot easier that way. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to find my list of steps we're going to use. So figure value you want to, okay, so first of all, we have to figure out what value we're going to, is a secret, or what values. In this case, it's going to be that account key. And then we're going to go, and I'll go through all these at one by one as we get to them. So first of all, let's go get our value. So I'm going to go over to my storage account. All right, so my storage account, I need to find its access key. So I go to the storage account, which is data lake, blob, storage, 50, whatever the number. And then here's a key. I go down to my access keys, and there's my secret key, which is going to be the value for my secret key. I copy that, all right? And then I go to my key vaults and key vault, okay? So now I already have one key vault set up, all right? So let's go ahead and create a new key vault. And I'm going to call this my demo, all right? And the name is going to be key vault for Databricks demo. Okay, a little long, I guess, so let's get rid of this key vault for Databricks. Okay, it's already in use, so let's put a 4 in there. Maybe that no one used that. Okay, very good. So Central, being in Dallas area, Central US, pricing tier, where is the cheapest one? Okay, I don't want a public endpoint, so keep it private. Go and create and review. It will validate, and I will hit create, and now I have a new key vault. So my key vault is in progress. You might want to watch some other videos on how to create a key vault. I didn't really go through any of the specifics there. Okay, that is done. So let's go ahead and create our, here's our key vault for Databricks demo. So I went KeyVault 4 Databricks demo, right? I went to my secrets. We'll go to secrets. Okay, well, I'm kind of glad I did it this way because I notice I see that my firewall is turned on and the client IP address is not authorized. So you might run into this when you create your KeyVault. So what I need to do is go down to my firewall section here. Okay, maybe it's under networking, I think. And you see the firewall here. Okay, so what you want to do is add existing, let's see. Okay, so what you probably have to do here is go and get your IP address, which you can easily do by saying, what's my IP address? I think that'll go right up to a set. Okay, so it's looking for the IP address here, and there it is, 107. I don't know, this is very good that you guys have that. I think I'm good to go then. So let's say save. It's updating. Let's go to my secrets. And I need to add that secret name, which is, let's just make sure I know what secret name I want to use. Databricks secret key, really original. That's okay. Okay, now, as you see, I can generate and import one, right? So I'm going to do a manual. I'm going to call it exactly what I just told you. And my value is going to be come over from my data lake blob, that key that I used before when I hard-coded it. I'll bring that over. And we'll enter that as my secret. You will not be able to see that secret. So if you don't, if you need to remember for some reason, you need to put it somewhere. Then I need to set my activation date, okay? One time I didn't set my activation date and it didn't work. So you will need to set that activation date and it will set it for the current time. So I'm going to say yes. It's enabled and create. Okay, so now my secret key is created. So I go to my Key Vault, which is what I just showed you. I go to the Key Vault properties for the respective Key Vault and copy the following. So I go and get my Vault URI and I save it to Notepad. So I'm in my Key Vault, right? Key Vault for Databricks demo, which if I go back here, you can see if I go right in Key Vault, I have two of them. So this is one of my vaults. This is one I'm going to use. Okay, now the next thing it says is I need to go and get this Vault URI and copy that to the Notepad. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do. Copy. Vault URI. Okay, let's go back to our next step. Now we need also the resource ID. And I look for the resource ID here. So I go down to properties and I see my resource ID is right there. So I copy that. Okay. Okay, my next step is number 4. Go and create a secret scope in Databricks. So A uses pattern. So HTTPS secrets scope. Okay, again, save it to the notebook. So I'm going to go save that to the notebook. Like I said, if I hadn't mentioned it, there's a lot of steps to this. A number of steps, not that many really. Then go on the overview screen of the Databricks workspace and copy the URL. Okay, so that's, let me show you that. Okay, so I go to Azure Databricks and I have my test work area right here. I click there. And what I need is this URI right here, the URL, right? That's what it's asking for. So copy that. /\ Databricks instance with the workspace copy URL you just saved. So we're going to go ahead and go back and we'll copy this. See? We'll copy this part. Let's copy. And I'm going to replace this with what I just copied there. Okay. So I guess I have less of a screen. Okay, so now I'll take that entire area and I'll paste it in here and run. And now we get to the create secret scope. All right, so now we're in the create secret scope of Azure Databricks. So now we go back to our steps and we're down at number 5, create a secret scope. So we enter the scope and make sure to save it in the notepad. So we need a scope name. I'll call the scope name Scope for Demo 3. I'm going to save it because I won't be able to find it later. I'm putting that in my notepad. And the next step is under Azure Key Vault section, enter the DNS name, which is entered from 3A above, which is the first thing we saved. So that's our Vault URI. So we're going to put our Vault URI in there. Here's our Vault URI. So we copy that from my notepad. I copy. I Control V and paste it in. Now I go to resource ID, which was the second thing I copied when I started, which is right there. And I paste. Okay, so I got everything in there. Got my new scope for demo 3 scope name. And I got it pointing back to my key vaults. So now Databricks is pointing to my key vault, all right, and using a scope. So I'm going to hit my create button. This is verifying, make sure I don't already have that in there. And it clarifies that the secret scope name, scope for demo 3, has been added. Manage secrets in this scope in Azure Key Vault with manage principal name. Okay, so I hit OK. Now I'm going to go to my workspace. And that might take a little while to create, I found. So I'm going to go to my create space, which is Key Vault secret key. So this might not work right away. But I'll show you that just because I want you to recognize that in case it doesn't work for you right away. You might have to wait 5 minutes or 10 minutes, okay? So this is where I stored the scope as scope for demo 3. And the key value I put in was Databricks secret key 3, right? And as you see, there's my secret key name and the scope name. Okay, so I'm in good order here. And my scope has had a little bit more time to get, you know, created over on the Databricks side. So I think this should be able to work now. Here's my account name. You might want to create your account name as a secret key too and other things. So, but this is, I just want to show you how to do one, and then you can do as many as you want or what you feel as you need. Okay. So now I'm going to run this. And as you know, you don't see the key anywhere. So now it's sending to the cluster, waiting for the cluster to start. It ran without error. So that's a good sign. So now we're going to see if we can run the next cell, which establishes the execution context, and that ran. Now we're going to get the folder information so we can run the files that are within it, and that ran fine. So it's so I run the cell, it's running, it's listing the files, and there it is. So our secret key was successful. The way we set it up was the correct way. So I'm not going to go through all the rest of this example. You can do that in another video if you like. But that's how you set up a secret key in the Azure Data Vault, and you connect it to the Azure Databricks. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. And if you'd like to see more of my demos, videos, please subscribe. Thanks again. Bye-bye.